to encourage the whole Rotary world to write and tell their stories. He believed that if every club shared its story, it would inspire new passion for Rotary and for our service. And Sam's story is no exception. Reflecting on his first Rotary experience, Sam recalled the invitation to join Rotary from his fellow Makerere University graduate professor, Charles Orwene, and I quote, "I kept on pushing it and dodging, but one day, for fear of disappointing him, I decided to attend. I started reading as much as I could find about Rotary, and I liked what I saw." In the course of his outstanding service to Rotary since 1978, he rose up to serve in almost every position you can name, from district governor to director to trustee, and then to president-elect. Using his passion for building Rotary globally, when he served as district governor, the number of clubs in Uganda swelled from 9 to 89. I know that those clubs will continue to thrive as they perpetuate Sam's legacy to provide opportunities for those in need with grace, good humor, and unfailing optimism. To those close to him and to those meeting him for the first time, it was clear that he would have been an outstanding Rotary president. Sam was a joy to work with, a progressive thinker, always thoughtful, considerate, and willing to hear all opinions. He will be sorely missed by all of us at Rotary, staff and volunteers alike. So although our flags fly at half past, our spirits are raised in remembrance of an inspiring life. He raised the Rotary flag to new heights, and we will do everything we can to honor his memory as our folks are with Nora and the Omori family at this difficult time. And this is the end of the letter from John Newman.